Hello internet and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. My name's Jack Finch and I'll be your host for today as we asked, what if the Basilosaurus didn't go extinct? Before we jump on in, make sure to hit that subscribe button and say hello in the comment box down below.
It takes a special friend.
Willie doesn't have a problem with me. Yeah. We appreciate each other.
We all love whales, right? Free Willie, one, two, and three? Well, maybe not three, but generally, the ocean is a much more interesting place just by adding whales. Killer whales, humpback whales, frightening whale of all time, the Basilosaurus, aka the King Lizard. How's that for a nickname? And what if we do away with the whole extinction thing and imagine an ocean where the King Lizard is still floating about, doing its thing, living it up as the Lord of the Whales? Now, that's where things get interesting, because the ocean would instantly become a much, much scarier place, as if it's not already. The Basilosaurus existed during the late Eocene period, between 34 to 40 million years ago, and was initially thought to be some sort of reptile, hence the whole saurus thing. Scientists quickly backtracked on that and rightfully crowned the King Lizard as a marine mammal due to its complex molar teeth, a trait found only in mammals and not reptiles. Now, it didn't get its nickname for being a great chess player. The Basilosaurus was estimated to measure between 24 to 30 meters long. That's bigger than a London double-decker bus, and also the same size as the current biggest whale in the world, the blue one. Because of this, we've got to imagine what the whale world would look like if the King Lizard was still around. Research has shown that the Basilosaurus was incredibly predatory, and it also had the tools to back it up. Research has found that a fully grown Basilosaurus could bite with a force of over 3,600 pounds at the position of its upper third premolar, about the same weight as a 1985 El Camino. This was enough to penetrate through skin, muscle, and bone, and pretty much crack open the skull of anything that lived in the ocean. Scientists also found that the King Lizard attacked its prey pretty similar to crocodiles. They discovered that the Basilosaurus could grip its victims with over 2,300 pounds of force, then toss it back along its jaws for a devastating final chomp. This guy was an incredibly capable hunter, pretty much the T-Rex of the ocean, and it's fairly safe to say that the peace-loving, krill-eating blue whale would probably be easy pickings for the Basilosaurus. In modern science, there's actually been cases of killer whales hunting them down in packs, which begs the question, how would the Basilosaurus fit into that equation? There are two possible scenarios that we can see. The first one would see the Basilosaurus snacking on blue whale just the same as a lion takes down a buffalo. You see, it'd be a fairly easy fight for the King Lizard, and it's down to one thing. The blue whale haven't got any teeth. Instead, they have what's called baleen plate, which essentially makes them giant sieves that swim through the ocean, catching whatever's unfortunate enough to stumble into the blue whale's path. And as we've said before, the Basilosaurus has got a lot of teeth. It wouldn't even be a fair fight. The blue whale would quickly become a thing of the past, and the King Lizard would take the crown as the biggest boy in the deep blue sea. But there's also a flip side to this. Why would the Basilosaurus expend all its energy on a blue whale when they're pretty much the exact same size as each other? That's a lot of work for some lunch. Which leads us to our second scenario, the Basilosaurus versus the killer whale. Whereas the orca are smart, intelligent creatures, the King Lizard was a relatively simple beast. It had one design, kill things and eat them. Compared to the killer whale though, it didn't have thousands of years of evolution on its side. And whereas killer whales use sophisticated echolocation to overcome obstacles, the Basilosaurus could only hear directionally in water, which is kind of like having an Xbox One but no controller to play it with. And as we've said before, if the killer whale can take down a blue whale, it's plausible that they'd also try and go for the Basilosaurus. What we'd see is the equivalent of a pack of timber wolves facing off against a T-Rex, but in the ocean. The deep blue sea would quickly become a battleground, with both sides of the whale war stockpiling for dominance. Fishing would become an even deadlier job than it is now. They'd be hailed as danger-loving heroes who braved the Basilosaurus sea. The price of tuna and salmon would skyrocket, and only millionaires would be able to afford sushi. Whale spotting would be outlawed for fear of death. Cruise ships would quickly become an adrenaline-fueled vacation rather than a relaxing holiday. Japan's tie on the whaling industry would quickly become forgotten, and anti-whaling campaigners would rejoice. Why would anyone attempt to fish for whale when there's a good chance that you'd run into a Basilosaurus? Yeah, didn't think so. With this constant whale battle raging on, overfishing would become a thing of the past. The planet's marine population would eventually return to an equal balance, and more importantly, humanity would probably think twice before exploiting the ocean. Again, everyone's a winner. That's all we've got time for today, guys. We hope you've enjoyed this video just as much as we have. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and stay tuned for our latest uploads. My name's been Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. And until next time, take it easy.